Yes. Did you hear
Okay.
me what I said?
No, sorry.
Okay, I was saying I'm not going to pick up my cherries against Islam because, I can say something negative, I can choose something negative. I don't want to do that. I want you, by your help, to show me something very positive, very good about Islam to convert all those Christians who are listening to Islam. Choose your best and leave the
So
rest for
we
me.
believe in one God.
You believe in one God.
Yes.
So this is the best argument you have?
Of course.
Okay. Well, there is a church. It's in
Of course.
there's a church in San Francisco. It's called the Church of Satan. They worship one God. His name is Satan. Secondly,
Okay, but that's not God.
okay, how we know that Allah is God then? What is the proof that Allah is God?
The Quran is a linguistic miracle.
Well, the Quran is full of mistakes, my friend. The Quran, how this Quran can be linguistic miracle? If you don't even speak Arabic, do you speak Arabic?
I don't, but I heard
Okay,
Islamic
you
Muslim scholars
all right.
talking about how.
Okay, look what the Arab they said about the Quran. The Arab was were laughing at the Quran in the time of Muhammad. Is that true, or I'm making things up?
They may have.
Okay, so how it is a miracle, but yet the Arab are making fun of it?
Because people try to deny God and try to make fun of him,
But you just said
so.
that the Quran is a miracle. How they can deny a miracle like this? Look what they said in chapter 8, verse number 31. And
They
when
even
our
deny
okay,
Jesus'
hold on.
miracles. They call him
No
Satan,
problem. No,
satanic.
no problem. Hold on. When our verses, the Quran, are recited to them, they say, "We have heard this Quran. We have heard it. If we wish, we can say the like it. It is nothing but
Okay,
the but it is nothing.
but
Hold
then
on.
you.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. It is nothing but the fairy tales of the ancient. Why they are saying this is the fairy tale of the ancient?
But they didn't produce anything like it.
Okay, I will go with you guys. They did not produce anything like it. Well, Muhammad himself, he copied from the Arab Quran. And you know what? I'm not going to use source from the infidels. I will use Islamic source to prove my point. Is that okay for you?
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
So if Muhammad he took from the Arab Quran, that's mean Muhammad is a fake prophet. Here we go.
Okay.
This is your prophet. This is Sahih Bukhari, very Sahih. It says that Umar said, the caliphate, I agreed with Allah in three things, or said, my Lord agree with me in three things. I said, O Allah, the messenger, what that you took the station of Abraham as a place of a prayer. And also I said, O Allah, messenger, God and bad presence visit you. Would you that you order the mothers of the believers to cover themselves with veil? So the divine verses, hijab, came. And then, read carefully. And then he continues saying, the divine verses about hijab revealed, I came to know the prophet and had blamed some of his wives. So I entered upon them and I said, would you either stop troubling the prophet or else Allah will give his apostle better wife than you? And when I came to one of his wives, she said to me, oh Umar, does Allah messenger have not what you could advise his wife that you advise him? And then you will see the verses came as I said. The verses came to Umar as he said to Muhammad. So Muhammad, he say a verse. The verse is taken from Umar word by word. Why Allah is taking Umar words, making it Quran? I thought nobody can make Quran like the Quran of Allah.
So basically in the Quran, doesn't it say that Allah, he uses us as vessels, like uses our
Okay,
hands?
hold on. But you are the one who said to me, produce like it if you can. So if Allah, so okay. So look at the contradiction here. Allah, he hear Umar. Umar, he make Quran. Allah, he take Umar words and he make it Quran, but yet nobody can make Quran like Allah. So who is the one who made the Quran?
Allah didn't make it. Allah gave it to him.
No, it says my Lord agree with me. Umar, he said it. Why, Umar is a prophet?
I don't know. He's not.
Okay, so and there's no way Allah he gave gave it to him. You are making things up now. Be careful. The Muslims are watching and listening. So you cannot say Allah gave it to him because that will make him a prophet. This is what the prophet is about. So Allah did not reveal the Quran to Umar, he revealed it to Muhammad. Do you agree or not?
Yes.
Okay, so Umar how he received the Quran before Allah. Read carefully. It says, so the verses came the same as I have said, which means word by word. And this is
so Sahih. Before Umar said it, it was not the word of God, but once Allah agreed with it, then it became the word of God.
Amazing. Thank you very much, guys. When Umar said it, it was not the word of God. But when Allah, he said, the word of Umar became the word of God. But you just said nobody can make Quran like it. And so Allah, he is copying from Umar, Quran, making it Quran. So Umar is the one who... Hold on.
Allah said it, it's not the same.
No problem. No, it's the same. So if I say shish kebab, hummus, falafel, and then because I am just a Christian prince, and then Allah, he say after me, hashish, hummus, falafel, that will make it Quran. And my word is not Quran. That's funny.
Well, if Allah says it, then it's not the same as a human saying it.
It doesn't matter. It's, first of all, Allah never said anything because according to your Quran, according to your religion, Muhammad, he never heard the voice of Allah. He received it from a man. He claimed to be, Muhammad, he claimed it's Jibreel. He came to him as a man. So he heard it from a man. A man, he said, the man, he said, the man, he said, and all of this was coming from Umar. So Umar is the one who made the Quran. Allah, he take the Quran of Umar, and you are saying, before when Umar he made this verse, it's not Quran yet, but it's the same words, word by word. So when you say nobody can make Quran like the Quran of Allah, it's a joke.
So you're just saying that if Allah says something, it's not going to be unique.
Well, you are saying that because this is your hadith, not my book, lady. It's your book saying that those verses came the same as I have said, which means obviously Muhammad, he heard Umar saying those words. Muhammad, he like it. He produced it as it is. He make it Quran.
But then if this hadith is saying that Umar, he wrote the Quran, then that means this is a fake hadith.
Ah, here we go. So that's a good idea, guys. It's a fake hadith. Islam is fake. So if Sahih al-Bukhari, the most authentic book after the Quran, is fake, that means we cannot trust anything in Islam. Okay, you know what? I will go with you. I will support you. Guys, this hadith is fake. What about the Quran? Isn't it the Quran says that the shaitan, he made Quran?
No.
Okay, let us see this verse. I want you to open with me. I don't know if you can see the screen or not. Chapter 2, verse 106.
Chapter 2,
verse 106. It says,
okay,
whatever verses or revelation we do abrogate or cause to be forgotten. Who is the one causing the Quran to be forgotten?
We never nullify a verse nor cause it to be forgotten. Unless we bring one better than it,
okay,
or similar to
okay.
it.
Okay, who is the one who caused the verse to be forgotten?
Allah.
Thank you very much. And why Allah, he do that?
So basically, if a verse was sent down for a particular period of time,
mm-hmm.
then at after that particular period of time, then it won't be necessary anymore. So okay. then it would change.
Guys, the Quran is not necessary anymore. We throw it in the trash. Look what the verse is saying. It says similar to it. So, okay, I will give you an example.
Hold on. Like the Old Testament and New Testament.
Hold on. No. The Old Testament is there. Nothing changed. God did not make me forget it. It's there word by word. So listen carefully here. Know what you said. Allah will make you forget the Quran, so he will make the same verse because it says similar. Does it say similar?
But we don't know what similar means.
Okay, now we know what similar word he's using my language, Arabic. نأتي بخير مثلها منها أو مثلها. It's exactly the same or better. Okay, let's go by one. Allah will cause me to forget of this verse. Let us make a verse. You know, I'm not trying to insult, but just to give you an example. Eat at apple, it is healthy. Okay, Allah now he make me forget the verse. Eat apple, it healthy. And now he will make a verse similar. Okay, eat apple. It is healthy. This is a similar verse. So what the point? Why Allah he make you forget Quran if he will make similar?
If one verse is abrogated, then he'll bring another verse
It's abrogated. Lady, as he says two options. Look, listen carefully, you know, abrogated or caused to be forgotten. So those who they are caused to be forgotten, Allah, he will make something better or similar. Don't mix things. So he will make you forget about eating apple. Allah, he said in the verse number 10, chapter number 10, verse number 1, eat apple. Okay. Allah, he make you forget this verse. He make a new chapter. It's chapter number 11, verse number 1. It says eat apple, but they are the same. Now, Allah is saying he will make similar verse, which doesn't make sense. This is a crazy talk. But if we go to different verse, and later I will be back here to this verse, but I'm trying to connect the dot to you so you can understand me.
Okay.
The Quran says that Allah, he will delete the satanic verses from the Quran.
For which one?
Is that correct?
For which?
Allah, he will delete the satanic verses from the Quran. Is that correct?
What are you talking about, satanic verses?
Exactly.
Well, what are you talking about?
Okay, guys, did she say, this lady, satanic verses? Did you say that or me?
No, you said that.
No, you are the one who said satanic verses, not me.
You just said satanic.
No, you are the one who said, are you talking about satanic verses?
No, you said satanic, and I said, are you talking about,
I said, is it true? My question was, is it true that Allah will dig the satan? They will delete the verses made by satanic? You said, are you talking about satanic verses?
Yeah, so okay. Those are the lies.
Okay, so you confirm. Okay, let's see if it's a lie. So this is a lie, guys. It's a lie. Read the verse with me. Chapter 22, verse number 52. Go ahead. I'm listening.
Never did we send a messenger or a prophet before you, but when he did recite revelation or narrated or spoke, Shaitan threw in it, but Allah abolishes that what Shaitan throws, then Allah establishes his revelations. And Allah is all-knower, all-wise.
Okay. So Allah will abolish what?
What Shaitan threw.
He throw where? Where he throw?
It does not say.
Okay. It says, here we go. He recite revelation. It's revelation. When he did recite the revelation or narrated or spoke, Shaitan, he throw some falsehood in it. Where in it? In it what?
In the speech.
In the speech, which is revelation.
Okay,
so now it's confirming the Quran that Shaitan, he made satanic verses, and Allah saying,
but Allah abolishes that.
Thank you very much. No problem, guys, but Allah abolish it. Okay, question. How Muhammad did not notice that this is satanic verses, yet Allah is the one who will abolish it? Look what happened. Your prophet, he was talking. Shaitan, he put words in his mouth. Muhammad, he did not notice that this is not from Allah, which means it was a perfect Quran for him. And then after he speak, he went home. Few days after, Jibreel, he come to his house. He knocked at the door. Khabibi Muhammad, what you did, Khabibi? He said, what? He said, the verses you say, those are not from Allah. Okay, hold on. The Quran says nobody can make Quran like the Quran of Allah. Who is going to be the judge? Muhammad. Because how we will know if this is from Allah or not? Muhammad is the prophet. Who is better than Muhammad to recognize which Quran, which is not? Muhammad himself.
It does not say that Muhammad knew that it was Shaitan. It does not say that Muhammad did not know that Shaitan threw it.
Thank you. No, it says he did not know. I can show you the interpretation. You want to show me the interpretation?
Yes.
All right, no problem. All right, give me a second, please. You see, here we don't talk from our own because that will not be right. As we said, when we debate Muslims, we debate them about their belief, not what we claim. All right. So we will go to the interpretation of the Quran and we will open it. I will put for you in front of you the official government website of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. This is official. This is not like a website made by somebody who's a Christian or, you know, this is very official. Okay. And we will see what happened. Just give me a second. Let us hope that this website will open, will work, because usually sometimes it doesn't work. It takes.
This is not like should
I wish you speak Arabic because I can show you all the interpretation in Arabic and you would die laughing. But anyway, we have to find it in English. Well, look like the website here is not opening, so I'm going to open it in Arabic temporarily. Enter the website open. All right.
Okay.
I will do it in an easy way, you know. I will search in the front of you in Google. Search.
But I don't think that that's the only interpretation for this.
I will show you any interpretation you like. Anyone. All of them. Actually, here we go. This website have all interpretation in one page. All right.
But I don't think any scholar would say this is the definitive interpretation for this verse.
Well, we will see. I mean, what do you mean any scholar says? So are you saying you Muslims, every one of you, make up his own mind about what he like? What, you know, he make up a religion? Do you have a religion or you have opinion?
Well, yeah, there are different opinions, right?
No. So you don't have a religion, it's called Islam. You have opinion about religion called Islam.
Well, we follow what the scholars, they study.
Okay.
They...
Let us read together. Here we go. Finally, the website opened so we can read. Would you please read for me the screen? I put it for you on the screen.
Oh, it's in Arabic.
No, now it's in English. I just move. It's going to take maybe a second for you to see it.
I still can't see it. Okay. Oh, there you go.
This is Tafsir al-Jalalain. It says.
Okay.
Yeah. Jibreel, Jibreel, let me make it short. You can read. You can take your time. I will post the link for the page in the chat so you can open it from your side. Here it says that Muhammad he recite worshipping the three daughters of Allah, Al-Lat wal-Uzza wa Manatu, the third. Their intercession is a must. This is what Muhammad said. It says, as a result, Shaitan cast them into his tongue without his, the Prophet, being aware of the following words. Those are the high-flying crayons, al-gharaniq, al-ula. Indeed, their intercession is hoped for, which means Muhammad is worshipping the three daughters of Allah. Not only is he saying words, he is saying it's a must to pray for them because they intercede for us. And so they, the men of Quraysh, where they are happy for this. And then Jibreel, read carefully, please. Jibreel, however, later informed him, the Prophet, of his, that this is Shaitan, had cast into his tongue. Do you see it?
Okay.
Okay. So Muhammad, he did recite the verses. He went home. He have no idea what he did. But how in the world that can happen? You see, Shaitan, he made him say words. Do Muhammad have ears? Do Muhammad, is Muhammad under control of Shaitan? Because let us say by mistake, I say the word. By mistake. You know, sometimes we do it actually. Sometimes I want to say something, I say something else. This is how it happened. But Muhammad here is worshipping the three daughters of Allah. Like, you know, I can make a mistake about, I want to say number... I ate intercession, and then he went home as if nothing happened. Then Jibreel later, he came and he informed him that this is not from Allah. So the Quran confirmed that Shaitan, he throw verses in the mouth of Muhammad, and Muhammad is the last one to know. What do you think?
So Al-Lat, Al-Uzza, and Manat, they are not goddesses. They were the pagan goddesses of that were worshipped
exactly,
by the
exactly,
ancient Arabs.
Exactly. So why Muhammad is worshipping them?
So he was not. It was Satan who put it in his,
Okay, no problem, guys. It's a Satan. So Satan in the mouth of Muhammad. So Muhammad in that moment, he is a satanic prophet because he is speaking for Satan.
No, Satan is speaking, not Muhammad.
No. Read carefully. He cast into his tongue. The tongue of who? The tongue of Muhammad. It was the tongue of your prophet. Read carefully with me. Satan casting them into his tongue without the Prophet being aware. So the Prophet is controlled by Shaitan. His tongue is speaking satanic verses. So your Prophet at that moment is a satanic prophet of Satan. Shaitan speaking through Muhammad, using the tongue of Muhammad. Muhammad is talking, but the fact it is Shaitan telling him what to say. That is a satanic prophet.
Well, if this contradicts the Quran, which says that that Satan doesn't have power,
authority over you. Thank you very much. You see, you are helping me. So look, guys, she just said it clearly that Muhammad is a fraud because.
The story is a fraud.
No. The Quran mentioned the story that Shaitan he threw in his speech. What are you talking about? So the Quran says that Shaitan he have no authority over the good believers, except the criminal. Inna ibadi, laysa laka alayhim sultan illa man ittaba'aka min al-ghawin. Chapter 15, verse number 42. So this verse proving to us that Muhammad is a criminal. He is an evildoer because the Quran confirmed, and thank you very much for mentioning this verse, you are a very smart girl, that this verse confirming that Muhammad must be an evil satanic person, because the verse in chapter 15 verse 42, certainly you shall have no authority, who is talking, Allah supposedly to Shaitan, over my slaves, any slave, any Muslim, except those who follow you, al-Ghawin. Who is the Ghawin? You know, criminals, mushrikeen, polytheists, the evildoers, etc., all kind of garbage. So Muhammad, in order for him to be controlled from Shaitan, he have to be of the Ghawin. And by your help, we prove it to be true.
Then that would mean that the verse does not say that Muhammad talked on behalf of Satan. It said that Satan put the verses in his mouth.
Okay, but Shaitan, in order for him to do that, he have to have authority. The verse here says you have no authority.
This is talking about Shaitan or
Shaitan. This is Shaitan. Read the conversation. If you go back a few verses, you will see that this is about Shaitan. Here we go. Allah, he said to Iblis. This is about Iblis specifically by name.
It's Iblis.
Iblis is the first Shaitan. You don't know who is Iblis. Iblis is the first Shaitan. According to your religion, Iblis is the first Satan. And when he came to the earth, Allah, he gave him a penis, and excuse my language, he gave him private part of a male in the right leg, and a private pair, private part of a female in the left leg. So when he shake this with this, he entered this into that, and then he laid 10 eggs. And I can show you the interpretation. So first Shaitan is this Shaitan. This is the father of all Shaitan in the world, so according to Islam. So this is Shaitan, Allah saying to him, you have no authority. This is the highest authority. Of all, the rest are his babies, are like his soldiers. This is the king of all Satans. The rest are his babies. You have no authority. And if the king have no authority, that means the one who follow, they have no authority too. I mean, they are lower. So this is the king of all evil, Satan himself, Iblis. He have no authority over my slaves. How this has happened to Muhammad?
This says Iblis, not Satan.
No, Iblis is the first Satan. Iblis is the father of all Satan.
So when this says that Iblis has no authority, does not say Shaitan has no authority.
Lady, Iblis is the highest authority of Satan because he is their father. He is the king, their king. So if the king cannot do it, the one who is lower than him, he can do it? Everyone is under the king. You know, if I am saying to a king, you have no authority to do that, you cannot do that. That's it. Which means you and your soldiers, you cannot do that. That's it. So Shaitan, he cannot do that.
Okay, then if Muhammad, as you say, was this, then why did he give to the poor, and why did he give?
Before we go there, lady, I like your response. Before we go there, I want to mention something. You see here, when we say that Muhammad, he made this verse, or the Quran saying this verse, any satanic verses he throw, I will take it off. How I know that this verse itself is not made by Satan? The Muslim, they start complaining. They said to him, you said to us, you worship Allah alone. Why you did say the three daughters of Allah? So Muhammad, in order to cover himself, he made this verse says, never we send all messengers before me heaven to them. But this is not true. Never happened to Moses, never happened to Isa, never happened to any prophet that Shaitan, he put satanic verses in their mouth. And this verse, there is no way it can be from God. Because God here confirming, which is according to the Quran, his God, that satanic verses was given and he will take it off. But this is obviously Shaitan. Shaitan saying, don't worry, this verse we will take it off. Here we go, we will take it off. And any verse Shaitan he gave to Muhammad, we will take it off. But how you can trust Muhammad after now that this verse itself is not coming from Shaitan? If Muhammad, he got Shaitan verses first time, he can get it second time. Where was Allah when Muhammad received satanic verses? He was asleep?
He allowed it to happen.
Thank you very much, guys. Did you hear it? He allowed it to happen. But isn't it the other verse in the Quran says, you have no authority over my servants? So how he allowed it to happen?
Okay, so I don't know the answer to this, but okay. I'll ask someone. And,
all right. But before we go, you want to talk about the good deeds, I know. But let us, because we're going to connect the dots for you to make it more clear. Was Muhammad controlled ever by black magic?
It was a sickness.
Sickness or black magic?
Black magic is sickness.
Black magic is sickness. It's called bewitch. How that is sickness? Is that a sickness? You take drugs for it? You take aspirin or
sick for some time, and then after he was healed by Allah.
Okay, but is it really sickness or black magic, which is the shaitan?
Black magic is from humans. They perform the black magic.
No. You see, the black magic, the first one who taught black magic, Allah, he opened a holy water school in the Babylon Tower. Is that correct?
It was with the two angels.
Yes, the two angels, and then the two angels they taught the shayateen too. Read the verse. Chapter 2, verse 102, Allah, he sent two angels, Harut and Marut, and they opened Holy Water School in the Babylon Tower next to Saddam Hussein house. And then they teach magic. And then this is in the Babylon. And then Shaitan, he used those magic to harm people. You see, they followed that.
It does not say that the Shaitan.
Read it. Okay, let's read.
Shaitan was teaching them.
No problem. It says, they followed what the Shaitan, the devils, gave them falsely of the magic. Do you see that shit on the screen? This is your Quran. This is your Islamic translation.
The men did it, not Shaitan.
Listen. Does it say there? They followed what the Shaitan, the devil, gave out falsely of the magic. Does it say that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
thank
the
you.
The men did it, not the Shaitan.
Okay. The man did it. The man did it. Okay. But the man did it. Did what?
Do black magic.
Okay, what is a black magic?
It's evil power.
Evil power. We go back to zero. You are the one who mentioned to me that Allah, he said to his servant that
it's the same black magic in the Bible where the Pharaoh turned the stick into snake.
No, you see, this is not a black magic. We don't believe in black magic. In the Bible, it's speaking about that the magic of Moshe, overcome the magic of the Pharaoh, which mean for them they thought that this is a magic, for us this is a miracle of God. This is not a magic. We don't believe magic is a lie. So here you Muslims believe in a magic, and the one who taught the first school is Allah. Why Allah is teaching magic, do you know?
It's to test mankind.
Thank you very much. Allah is testing Muhammad.
Why not?
Okay, by doing what exactly? How he tested him? What the black magic? What the black magic did to Muhammad? Let us see how this test work.
It shows if he still stays with the faith.
Okay, but look what the magic did to him. Did not affect his faith. Affect his private part. Read carefully with me. The Prophet continued for such and such period of time, imagining that he had sexual intercourse with his wife, but in fact he did not. Is that the faith in Islam? Is your private the private part of a man? Is Muhammad religion in his private part?
Where does it say that?
This is Sahih al-Bukhari, and this is the hadith number. I'm showing you on the screen. The Prophet continued for such and such a period of time, imagining that he had slept, between two brackets, has sexual relation with his wives, and in fact he did not. Why Allah doing that to the Muhammad private part? What does this have to do with the trial of religion? The guy, still he is a prophet, and now he imagined himself doing things, so he lost his mind. And this is Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 6063. And this is not only for sex, for everything. So look what you are saying to me. Allah, he allowed this to happen. Allah, he sent two angels to open a school to teach black magic, and black magic will be affected the prophet, and the prophet will start imagining that he had done a thing, but in fact he did not, which means the prophet, he lost his mind. And now we need to ask ourselves, if the prophet, he imagined things, how we can trust that he saw angel, he heard the angel talked to him, the guy, he lost his mind, he's crazy.
So the reason why we can trust is that the Quran gives an evidence that no mankind can produce something like it.
We just showed you that Umar and Shaitan, they produce. What do you want more? We just showed you that. How you repeat the same thing? I just showed you that Umar, Muhammad copy from Umar, many verses in the Quran. And here we go, Shaitan, he is making Quran. And Muhammad, the last one to notice. And the verse about Allah will delete the satanic verses, maybe this one too is from Shaitan to make us relax and will not go over it. And here now we find that Muhammad is a crazy man. He lost his mind. Listen, if I say to you, lady, I do not know your name. I want to speak to you really with respect, but I want to listen to me carefully. If I say to you, let's say you are a doctor and I am a person coming to you. I say, okay, my name is a Christian. I imagine myself seeing somebody talking to me. What you will say to me? Be honest. I imagine, and it's true. I imagine. It's not true, which means it's not. I don't see anyone really. I'm imagining. What do you think? What do you will say to me? What is your opinion as a doctor, as a somebody educated, smart, and I need your help? I imagine myself speaking to people, or even make a relationship with my wife, but in fact it did not happen. What you will say to me? What happened to me?
So it depends. So if it could either be a natural explanation, like schizophrenia, okay, or a disease like that, or it could be supernatural, like a divine test, or from Allah or a jinn or something like that.
Okay, hold on, guys. It can be that Muhammad, he have two different personality and he is mentally ill. Or it can be that it is a trial from Allah. Okay, hold on.
But if you go to the Quran in Surah An-Nasr, it says, when there comes Allah's victory and conquest, and you see the people entering Allah's religion in multitudes, and we see that today, people entering Islam, the Deen al-Haq, and that's actually a prophecy that came true. So that's how we know.
First of all, this is not a prophecy. This is about the time of Muhammad. They enter into Islam when he became victorious, and he want to kill anyone who will not convert. So you just get your prophet busted. This is not a prophecy. This is in his time. You can open the interpretation, and you see the people enter Allah religion in crowd when victory came. Victory came. This is in the time of Muhammad. He attacked them. He killed the Muslima, and now he became victorious, and nobody enemy against him. And now everybody is coming to Islam by tens of thousands. Before, they were rejecting, they don't want to believe. And then when Muhammad died, everybody left almost. And then they start the war of apostate to force them to go back to Islam. And you know the story, I'm sure. Now, so this is not a prophecy. This is a stupid prophecy, because this has happened in his time. How this can be a prophecy? But let me show you a prophecy, as long as you are mentioning a prophecy. Do you know where hell is coming from?
Hell?
Yeah.
From the sky.
From where?
From the sky.
Yeah, but where exactly?
It says hail is generated in a thunderstorm.
Thank you.
It is really just frozen.
So if I say to you that my dad, he taught me, or my teacher taught me, that there is mountains and God, he break hail from it and he throw it at us. What you will say?
If it's literal, then it would be false.
Okay, well, this is literal. Here we go. This is your prophet. He's talking about how the rain come and how the hail come. And he is saying that, and look, the Muslim, they try to cover the shame. They say, sky hail like mountains. There's no like. There's no similar to mountains. It is from mountains. And if it, let us open the interpretation just to show you how Muslims, they try to translate, a specific translator, how to try to fool poor people who don't understand Arabic. This is the tafsir. You see, I'm reading your Islamic website just to show you how the shame works. I feel really sorry for those Muslims. Like this lady, she is, I can tell she is a good lady, you know. She is a victim of the lies. Chapter 24, verse number 43. In front of your eyes, I will do the read interpretation. 24, 43. Remember, here we go. This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Jordan. And the reason I'm using it, because it's in English. They have English translation. That's all. Otherwise, all websites are the same for me. Let us hope it's going to open, because this website, sometimes it takes time to open. We can open Ibn Kathir if this one doesn't work. Let me go to Ibn Kathir, hold on, because this one taking forever. And again, I respect that this lady, she said, if this is true, this is literal, this is false. This is cannot be from God. I respect that on you. And I hope that you will stand with your words, and I believe you will do. Because there is no way God will say such a silly thing. I agree with you. All right. Let us go and see. All right. Look like this website start working again, so we will use it. Thank God. All right. I want you to read with me, please. Here we go. This is Tafsir al-Jalalain in front of your eyes. Haven't you seen God, blah, blah, blah. And then he says, and he sent down from heaven, out of the mountains, min jibalin, min is extra, that is therein, in heaven, fiha, substitute for min, etc. You know, trying to explain Arabic, from the heaven, with repetition of genitive, preparation, hail, and he sent down, and he submit to those who he don't like. Okay, so Allah, he sent hail from mountains in heaven. Let us see different interpretation. Maybe this one is not clear for you. Let us see Ibn Abbas, the cousin of the Prophet, the highest of the scholars of Islam, the one who Muhammad, he prayed for him to be the ink of scholars, Hibrul Ummah. Allah, he sent hail from mountains in heaven. He break hail and he sent it on us. This website is taking forever to open, as usual. I should make a donation to the King of Jordan so he can get a better hosting website. You know? Like, come on.
This is Tafsir al-Jalalain.
Yes, this is al-Jalalain. And remember, any tafsir you see in English is far away from the tafsir in Arabic. In Arabic, it's totally different, because in English, they try to make it nicer.
Are you going to put up a tafsir Ibn Abbas?
Yeah, I'm trying to open it, Ibn Abbas, but it's...
Ibn Abbas, scholars have debated whether it's reliable or not.
Okay, what scholar is your choice?
You can do... Ibn Kathir.
Okay. Here we go. This page here have all the interpretation. Let us see. This is Ibn Kathir. So do you agree with Ibn Kathir? Is Ibn Kathir your best scholar?
He's one of the, like, the top scholars.
But what make him what make him the top?
His just his level of study and the amount of work he put into his tafsir.
So if Ibn Kathir says something stupid, you'll reject him or you will accept him?
He's still a man. We don't accept everything he says.
Okay.
But
so who is the one who is qualified to explain the Quran for you? Because I'm trying to be fair with you. Can we accept Ibn Kathir for anything, or only it's a mood stuff? Like, it's depend what you like.
If it matches with what the Quran says, and
well, the Quran says in Arabic clearly, "Min jibalin fiha." Min baradin fayusib. There's no like mountains. There's nowhere it says the summer of mountain. So
go to chapter 3, chapter 3, verse 7. It says, "It is He who revealed to you the book. Some of its verses are definitive. They are the foundation of the book, and others are unspecific. As for those in whose hearts are is deviation, they follow the unspecific part, seeking dissent and seeking to derive an interpretation. But none knows its interpretation except Allah."
Okay, so look what you just said. You just got your prophet busted, because this is mean. Muhammad saying that I say things nobody can explain save Allah. So why he say it to us? If this is a message to be given to us so we can understand about God, and then there's nobody will understand the message of God. So what the point of this message of God? Yet you are saying that this Quran have a lot of verses with its mutashabihat, and the purpose of them to make us sick. I thought the Quran is a healing book for the believers and for people to believe. So how this book is going to heal me, but it's full of things which can be making me sick? So this is cannot be from God. This is obviously from Shaitan again, because God will not send me a book to fool me and to make me sick. Read carefully what you just said. Some of the verses, nobody knows their meaning save Allah. What the purpose of them? What the purpose? That those, it's to seek fitna. But look here, in the between translation, this says the polytheism. That's false, because the one who believe in the Quran is the one who will have the fitna, not those who don't believe in the Quran. The one who don't believe in the Quran, he will laugh at it. Those who believe in the Quran, they will not understand the meaning of the verses, so that will make them having sickness. What kind of God he says such a thing? Same time.
Would you say that you understand every verse from the Bible?
My friend, I understand God, he speaks to us. The Bible is a private message, which means every word Jesus he speaks to you as a person, which means you have your own life, you have your own experience, you have your own ability, and God, he speaks to you, he go down to your level. The Bible is not a book you sing, jingle bells all the way, and then nobody understand what he's saying. The Bible is a message to you, private message, so you can go and read any verse Jesus said. You will see how amazing it is.
So then why are there like Catholics, Protestants, and Orthodox? Well, if God speaks to them the same way.
Well, that's a wonderful question. Still, that will not change anything, because being different will not make us not the Christians, because being different will make us. Jesus said, whoever believe in me will go to heaven. But the Quran, your prophet said, that my nation will be 73 sect and only one of them will go to heaven. Which means 71 sect is the Jews. 72 sect is the Christians. 73 sect is the Muslims. And only one will go to heaven. And this is Sahih Hadith, as you see in the screen. So the most divided belief, according to your prophet, not to me, is Islam. So if your argument, why there is a Catholic and Protestant, still Christianity doesn't make any difference. Whoever believe in me and I will live. In Islam, no. There is 73 sect. Only one will go to heaven. Which one is the minority? Because Muhammad, he says, بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسوف يعود غريبا. Islam starts as a small strange religion and it will end as a small strange religion. Few only will believe. And as you see, only one small tiny sect will go in heaven. The rest will go to hell. Now, which one? Each one of them says, I am the one who will go to heaven. And the funny, you just quote for me a verse from the Quran saying that Allah, he puts sickness in the heart of the Muslims, so he will divide them and make them sect, and then only one will go to heaven. What kind of God?
That's the Quran says that happens to the Christians.
What is that? What is that? Say again.
The Quran says the Christians will be divided.
The Quran? Okay, hold on. Let me show you what the Quran is saying. The Quran is saying that Allah will spread hatred and enmity between the Christians so he can divide them, correct? Is that true?
Between them.
Yes. Who is the one who will spread hatred between them?
Allah.
Thank you. So what Shaitan do for a living? If Allah spread hatred between us, what Shaitan is doing for a living? What is the job?
Allah does it by sending Satan as a trial.
Okay, so Shaitan, he worked for Allah, and Allah is the boss. Thank you very much, guys. We have the big boss.
Even the Bible says that.
Hold on, no. You see, first of all, you are making things up. It says, the verse.
I can show you.
Hold on, the verse saying, and from those who call themselves Christians, we took their covenant, but they have an abundant good part of it, a message, etc. So we planted among them enmity and hatred. Where it says that Allah, he sent Shaitan. He, it says we.
Yeah, how he does it is by sending Shaitan.
Okay, do Allah want us to convert to Islam, or he want us to stay Christians and be wrong?
He wants everyone to convert to Islam.
Okay, so how this is will work if you are spreading hatred between us and enmity until Judgment Day? How that will help me to become a Muslim?
It's because the Christians, their hearts are stone.
Okay, but this is not the Quran saying. The Quran saying the most close to the Muslims is those who they are the Christians. This is contradiction.
But the Quran says you can't take them as people who protect you from war.
Exactly. You can't take them as a friend because Allah is Shaitan. He don't want you to be a friend to me. So Christ, he said to me, pray for the Muslims, love the Muslims, be good to the Muslims. Allah says, don't be a friend to them Christians. Don't be nice to them. You know, kill them wherever you find them. Even your prophet, he said. Well, let me ask you, if you see a Christian in the street, are you going to push him in the mud?
No.
Why not?
That's not what Islam teaches.
But is that like because you are a good person or because it's not Islam teaching? What does Islam teach you?
It's to respect all religions and beliefs.
Okay. I'm going to commit suicide if you can show me where it says that. Here we go. This is your prophet saying, if you see a Christian or a Jew in the street, you have to force him to walk in the sewage. You have to harass him and you have to force him to walk in the sewage. Don't greet the Jews and the Christians.
Maybe during war.
No, this is in the street. People walk in the street. This is what war? People walk in the street. This is war. People
Where
walking.
Where is the background of this hadith?
It doesn't matter. People walking in the street. I am walking in the street and I am a Christian. Why you want to force? He's not saying force the soldiers. He is not saying force the bad person. No, he's saying don't greet the Jews and anyone is a Jew, anyone is a Christian. Don't greet them, and then if you when you see them, force them to walk in the sewage. What kind of a prophet this prophet is, and you are the one who said this is against Islam.
That's during war.
My friend, you are always in war with the Christians. You just read for me the Quran saying Allah will spread hatred and enmity until Judgment Day. So you are saying to me, you are now trying to cover up for your prophet. In the beginning, you said this is disgusting and now it's okay. So you are saying during war, if I go right now to Indonesia and I'm an American citizen, we can force the Muslims to walk in the sewage. This is what you are saying.
Allah won't give you that power.
Hmm. So it's okay for you now to force a Christian to walk in the sewage. Allah gave you the power. Okay. Suddenly it became an okay. When I asked you, you said this is not good. Not good.
If it's during war, then...
Where it says during war? Where it says during war? It says if you see them in the street, what war?
Yeah, so they're your enemies, right?
They are walking in the street. What enemy? Living with you in the town.
Where does it say that?
Well, they are walking in the street. They are greeting you, actually. He's saying, don't greet them. Don't greet them. Somebody in war, he will greet you, say to you, Shalom. Don't you see? Don't you read? Do you know how to read? Don't greet them. Don't say peace to them. What is war?
Okay, I'll ask someone about this hadith.
What he will say to you? He will say to you, yeah, sister, you know, those Christians, we should humiliate them. Isn't it the Quran in chapter 9, verse 29, says that you have a duty to humiliate the Christians?
During war.
Okay, after you enter my city. Let us say, the Muslim came to my city, they surrounded the city, they said, surrender to our army. After you enter the city, still you are going to force me to walk in the sewage or no?
If we're still in war, then maybe.
You just took my city, still in war? There's civilian inside, there's no soldiers.
If you're trying to attack me or
lady, no Christian attack your prophet. He is the one who came to their cities, occupy them. Look how false you Muslims are. So you are saying to me, you come to my town, you attack my town, you take my town, and then you force me in the sewage, and you say this is okay.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Okay, let me, you know what, I will give you a good chance to defend your cult. You said to me the Quran proved, until now you gave me nothing, proving the Quran to be from God. We showed you that Umar making Quran, Shaitan making Quran, and Muhammad, he have no idea what they are saying. And even you gave me a clear proof that the Quran full of verses, nobody knows what they mean, because Muhammad obviously is a thief. And why Muhammad, you do not know? Even Muhammad do not know what the meaning of the Quran. Have you ever heard of a prophet you do not know? As an example, the Muslim, they claim that the Quran full of scientific verses. Is that true?
The Quran talks about the Big Bang.
Okay, the Big Bang. Guys, the Quran speak about the Big Bang. Okay, guys, the Quran speak about the Big Bang. So Muhammad must be a liar, because Muhammad, he said the following. You see how you Muslims, you help me to expose your prophet? How many Muslims will leave Islam today? Let us see how many. This is your prophet explaining the Big Bang, which you are claiming that Islam is speaking about it. Muslims fabricate stories. They lie to themselves, with my respect to you. Look what your prophet said. Who said that? Your prophet, not me. How Allah created the earth and the heaven? Read with me, please. Do you see the screen?
I see it, but it's not up yet.
All right. This is your prophet, and this is Sahih Hadith. This is Sahih Muslim. Allah exalted the glory, the glorious, created the clay on Saturday. The Big Bang says Allah, he created the clay on Saturday. Is that what the Big Bang says?
So the Big Bang is basically like a expansion of matter.
The Big Bang is nothing. There's no matter can was exist, and there's explosion happened, and everything exists in the same time.
Hold on. That's actually
according to you, okay, listen. So according to the Big Bang, is the first thing became exist is the clay in Saturday? Yes or no?
It may have.
So Big Bang, guys, the Big Bang theory, believe in Saturday. So the first day was Saturday, and the first thing was created. The Big Bang is a clay. Okay, second day, Allah created the mountains. Third day on Sunday, and then Allah, he created the trees on Monday. And then he created the entire in labor in Tuesday. And he created the light in Wednesday. This is what the Big Bang saying?
The Big Bang isn't complete yet, so scientists are still studying about it.
So they will discover there's a Saturday and Sunday and the light in Wednesday and etc. later, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay, exactly. That's very smart of you. But let me ask you, how many days took Allah to create the earth and the heaven?
6 days?
6 days.
I'm not entirely sure.
Yeah, the Quran says 6 days, exactly. So how many days here in the hadith? How your prophet, he say what he just said. Because if we count the words here, how many days, we will find that there are seven. Read with me carefully.
Yeah. If a hadith contradicts the Quran, then it's not reliable.
Well, isn't it the Quran is a hadith too?
The hadith in the Quran, the word hadith is not talking about the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
No,
it's basically.
No, it is about Muhammad. It's the one who said that is Muhammad.
Yes, but the word hadith came before the sunnah, like when it was compiled.
You have no idea what you are talking about. The Quran itself is a hadith, isn't it? The Quran says the best of the books is a hadith. The best
yes,
of
but
the hadith.
What does hadith mean? It means speech.
Speech. Thank you very much. So both of them coming from Muhammad. So if Muhammad speaks something, doesn't matter what is Quran or normal speech, it have to be
when
truthful.
When the Quran talks about hadith, it's talking about Allah's speech, not Muhammad's speech.
Thank you, but isn't it Allah, he speak on through Muhammad? So are you saying Muhammad is making things up now? But your prophet, when he said Allah created the clay in Saturday, he was lying? This is not Allah saying that?
Yeah, so if the Quran, if the hadith contradicts the Quran, then the hadith is not reliable.
Hmm. So is the Quran reliable?
Yes.
Okay, let me ask you. According to the Quran, where the sperm of the man is coming from?
I'm not sure.
What do you think, according to science?
I'm not a doctor to say, sorry.
But you've been in school before, no?
I have, but I'm not a professional.
Aren't you a lady, adult?
I am.
Okay, so now maybe I don't know if you are married or not. So you do not, you never heard where the sperm of the man coming from?
Well, I have an idea, but I'm not sure.
Okay, what is the idea? What
I'm
is the idea you have?
Doctor.
We are talking about science now. There is no shame. So where is the sperm is coming from?
Well, firstly, sorry, what?
Where is the sperm of the man coming from, and what the sperm will be?
The sperm comes from the male genitalia.
Okay. Is it coming from the testicles of the man? And around it?
I'm not a doctor, so
okay.
I wouldn't know.
According to the Quran, the sperm of the man is coming from the back.
As I'm aware of, no.
Okay. So how the Quran says women have a sperm coming from their chest location?
That may be talking about breast milk.
Breast nut? What? Breast what? Breast milk. So now the milk became a sperm? I will open for you your favorite scholar, Ibn Kathir, the one you like. Let us see what Ibn Kathir said about
okay.
What how Allah he made the baby come to exist. Here we go. This is Ibn Kathir, not me. He is a created you from water gushing forth, meaning the sexual fluid come from out bursting forth from the man and the woman. From what? From the man and the woman. It's a sexual and a fluid and the bursting forth. So it's coming out. This is orgasm, which is false, because the women orgasm is not will make the baby. Thus the child produced from both of them by permission of Allah, continue, proceeding from between the backbone and the ribs, meaning the backbone of the man and the ribs of the woman, which is referring to the hair chest. Proceeding from between the backbone and the ribs, the backbone of the man and the ribs of the woman, the fluid is yellow and fine in texture. This is for the women. And the child will not be born except from both of them, i.e. their sexual fluid. Do you believe in this madness?
again, I'm not a doctor to say whether this is right or wrong.
Okay, I will give you 10,000 years to search the internet and you will find that this is nothing but garbage. There's no way this can be from God. A man, he claimed that women have orgasm and that yellow fine texture will make the baby. If we go to the hadith, which is not contradicting the Quran, so you don't have the excuse now to say contradict the Quran, your prophet said that if the women have orgasm first, the baby will be like her, which means a female, and look like her. If the man have orgasm, the baby will look like him. Do you agree with that?
If Muhammad said it, then yes.
Okay, but that means Muhammad is a false prophet, because this is absolutely false. Everybody is laughing. This is far away from any scientific fact. Everybody is going crazy. Look what people are saying in the chat. So my lady, you are trying just because you are a Muslim, whatever Muhammad is, say you accept, even if it's funny and stupid. Okay, let us make it simple for you. So Muhammad, if Muhammad is saying that, you agree with it. Is that okay? Anything Muhammad will say, you agree with it. Okay. Now, if we ask you, in the heaven of Allah, what Allah will give you as a woman?
I am anything we desire, we will obtain in Jannah.
Okay. Is that including if a woman, she like to have sexual relationship with a woman?
So the Jannah of Allah is pure. So if people desire these things, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not allow them to enter Jannah.
How you just told me, anything you desire. You just told me anything you desire. And now you are saying to me, if you desire something Allah don't agree with, He will not give it to you. So it was a fraud promise.
No, if you desire something good, then Allah will give it to you.
Ah, only if it's good. Okay, like what? Look what your prophet saying. This is Jami' al-Tirmidhi. Your prophet saying, indeed, in paradise there is a market in which there is no buying nor selling except for images of men and women. This is the first Playboy magazine in the space. So whenever a man desire an image, he enter it. You're a prophet promising men, not you, a Playboy magazine have images of men and women.
Is this hadith sahih or?
All the hadith which is embarrassing are not sahih, I guarantee you. I just showed you a hadith is sahih, you said you rejected a second ago. You forgot?
Not everything from Sahih Bukhari is hadith.
Here we go,
sahih.
Guys. You know, is this hadith is sahih? I just showed you a hadith is sahih, you didn't accept it.
Yes, because it contradicted the Quran.
So how it is sahih, but it's contradicted the Quran? Because sahih means authentic.
No, not everything in Sahih Bukhari is sahih.
Lady, it is authentic. Authentic mean what? It mean it is checked and it passed and it is the Prophet who said that. So how it can be authentic? The Prophet said it and yet you don't accept it.
So we don't know if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it.
So how you know that this hadith is not said by the Prophet? How you know the Quran said by the Prophet anyway?
Oh, because it's in chain. We have
it's in chain. Well, the hadith I just showed you, the one before it, it was in chain. It says sahih and you reject it.
Well, it contradicts the Quran, so then it's not correct.
Okay, so if something contradicts the Quran, we should not accept. You agree?
If something contradicts the Quran, then we cannot accept it.
All right. There's nowhere in the Quran it says that the muta is not to be practiced no more. Can you show me a verse says don't do muta no more?
Well, it says zina is wrong.
No, so, I'm not talking about zina. Zina is. So are you saying muta is zina?
Well, it is right now.
Ah, muta is guys. Muta is adultery right now. So Allah, He approved adultery in the time of Muhammad.
But during the time of the Prophet, it was not.
In the time of the Prophet, it was a holy thing to do. Now it is haram. Why it's haram now?
Because it was only for during war.
Hold on. You can rent women during war?
It's not renting. It's essentially, it's because men have like a desire.
Who said it's not renting? Who is the one who said that? You or somebody told you that? Okay, here we go. This is your Islamic website. This is al-islam.org. Read with me in the screen, please. This is your Islamic, you know, website written by your leaders. Explain to us al-muta, the pillars of muta. It says here that muta is a kind of rental. It is kind of what? Rental. In defining rental. Read carefully with me. This is not me talking. This is you, Muslims, talking about the muta. Let us see. How Muslims they rent muta, rent women. Allah, he is allowing Muslim to rent women. Muslim women are rented by Muslim men legally. And she is saying it's okay in that time of Muhammad. It says, in some work, special term is applied to women who participate in muta. Musta'ajara, which means rented. Rented women. Muta is considered as a kind of rental because, in general, a man's basic aim is kind of marriage, is sexual enjoyment. So you are saying to me that your prophet, he was in war. He allowed Muslim women to rent themselves to men to have boom boom with them. And that is okay.
If it's during war, then I don't see a problem with it.
So the women who take off her panty because somebody gave her $5 during war, is she a good woman?
I do not know. I have to okay. Ask.
You see, I will go with your answer, which is I find it very silly. Muslims now in war everywhere. There's war in Iraq. There's war in Libya. There's war everywhere. Can Muslim men rent Muslim women?
No, it was only during the time of the Prophet.
But you just say this is because of war. So war is exist. Nothing changed. So why in the time of the Prophet was okay and now it's not okay? If this is the reason, the war, well, they are in war. There's war in Iraq. There's war in Syria. There's war in Yemen. There's war in Egypt. There's war everywhere. So I can rent women or I cannot.
I'm not really sure, so I can probably ask someone and then I can tell you what they told me.
Okay, let me ask you. The Shia, they still practice muta. Why? And the Muslim Sunni, they are not practicing muta. Why?
The Shia don't accept the hadith that...
Okay, but you are the one, hold on, but you are the one who said to me, if the hadith contradict the Quran, we will not accept. The muta is a verse in the Quran. The hadith says that the Prophet, he forbid the muta. So how you see, look what you did to yourself. How you a second ago, you rejected the hadith because you said it's contradict the Quran, I don't accept it. But yet you accept the hadith about the muta, which contradict the Quran. The Shia says
that zina is wrong.
Okay, hold on, there's nowhere in the Quran that says muta is zina. The Quran says you can rent women and you can pay them money for enjoying it, which means their private part. So you are the one shooting yourself in the foot. You said if a hadith contradict the Quran, you reject the hadith. Look what happened now. You are rejecting the Quran because of a hadith.
So when the Quran says something and the hadith says something different, then you have to reject the hadith. But the Quran does say that zina is wrong, and so that hadith is supporting zina.
No. You see, don't fabricate things. First of all, if Allah says you do muta, how you can call this is zina? Shame on you. With my respect to you, and the other one insult. You are insulting Allah now. Don't do that, please, in front of me. That's haram. If Allah says you do muta, and now you are saying muta is zina, so you are saying to me that Allah in the time of Muhammad says do zina. She hang up. Call me back. Do you see how they play games? We don't debate Muslims. You know, we have to, they play games. It's like a cat and a mice. You know, you have to go in the corner, try to hold them from their tail. No honesty. When they want, they reject. When they want, they accept. When they want, she do not know. She is a lady. And she do not know where the sperm of the man is coming. She do not know if the women have a sperm or not. Suddenly she do not know. She's a baby, she's 6 months old. She never heard of this before. Taqiyya, to defend Islam, this is the truth. But you know, I respect this lady. She is way more brave than those potatoes who call themselves, they grow in beard. Look, you see, I spoke to her kindly. I go down to her level with the education. And still I respect her because she is more brave than all those men who claim to be men. Is that right? She is a woman. She is better than those sheikhs who have long beard. They don't dare to call me. Look, I spoke to her nicely. I didn't say anything. And I go down to her level. I'm going with her wherever she goes. As if I'm talking to a child. But the most amazing thing, when they try to defend, they shoot their prophet. Not only in his foot, they shot him in private places. She just agreed that muta is a zina. So Allah in the Quran approve and encourage zina. Did you hear it? Fantastic. She hang up because now she said, uh-oh, what I did. This is zina. So the hypocrite now, they accept the hadith which is contradict the Quran. But when they want, they say, we don't accept the hadith is contradicting the Quran. That is Islam, my friend. Islam is, there's a God, his name is Allah. He asks his followers to rent women. And those women are good believers. A good woman, she rent her private part. The Prophet of Allah, he said, any believing person, they agree to have muta, let them do muta, 3 days, three nights. If they like to increase, they increase. Read carefully. This is Al-Bukhari. This is Al-Bukhari. Any man, if a man and a woman agree to do muta, even the name muta, you know what muta mean? It's a shame. Muta is a sexual joy. Do muta. If a man and a woman agree to do boom boom for 3 days, and you are in war and now you have time to have boom boom for 3 days. What kind of war this war is? There is no war. And let us say there is a war. You are not the first one who go in war and they have wives. So now you are saying to me, if I am going away from my home and my wife with me, okay, I can rent a woman in the hotel. I go to Las Vegas, I rent a woman because I am in war. Any man, any woman, they agree to do boom, boom for 3 days. Let them do three days, three nights. And if they like to increase, they increase. And here we need to ask ourselves, how he make it lawful and then how he make it unlawful? Because people, they start laughing at him. This guy, he claimed to be a prophet of God, claiming to that he brought decency. But look what he's doing. They are jumping on the top of each other as if they are cats. Women, they became sex toys. Men, they became pimps. This is Islam. And this is why she hang up. Because she found that she got her prophet busted with no mercy. But I'm so happy that she said clearly that muta is zina. We cannot do muta now because it is zina. Allah forbid zina. We have the prophet of zina. Take a note, please. This lady, I think she's from Indonesia, I don't know. She confirmed that the prophet of Allah is a prophet of zina. She confirmed that the prophet of Allah receives satanic verses. She confirmed that Umar, he made Quran before Allah. And when Umar, he said, this is not Quran. But when Allah, he said, the word of Umar, this is Quran. It's a priceless quote. Oh boy. You know, always when you speak to a Muslim, you have to go with their, you have to give them a hope. It's like doing fishing. Don't hit in the head right away. It's like the snowball. Let the snowball go big until it became a mountain, and then he will find himself trapped. This is what we have to do. Zina means adultery, fornication. Zina means fornication. So this is the prophet of fornication, the god of fornication. He allowed Muslim women to rent it, to rent. Yeah. Who can make Quran like this Quran? This is the most stupid Quran. What Quran? This is the most stupid, funny book. We are the Arab Christian. We are laughing at this book from the first day. And after all the occupation and paying jizya and humiliation, still we reject it because it's stupid. Otherwise, why we reject it if it's amazing and it's garbage? What is this? Yeah, the Muslim, they give us dislike. That's an honor for us. That means we are doing a great job. You see, the Muslims, when they come to my page, right away they give dislike. Christians, they don't do that. Christian, you have to ask them, like, you know, can you give like? And I'm not going to do that. I mean, you do like, you don't like, I don't care. I don't even keep my videos. Feel free to call me back, lady, and you are welcome. You know, I respect that you are brave more than the rest of the Muslims. At least you are better, more brave than those who have a beard and they are 6 foot tall and they call themselves Mimi. And they wear a pink t-shirt and they go to the, and they claim that you are finished, boy. You are finished. Yeah. She's more brave than them. Look, she dared to call me. From the first page in the Quran to the last page of the Quran is a stupid book. The Prophet, Allah, he allowed the black magic to be in the Prophet. Look at this madness. Okay, hold on. To do what? As a trial. Trial for what? His private part? I thought Allah, he sent a dish of shish kebab. He ate it. He got the power of 40 men. How now Allah want to make his private part flat? The prophet of fornication. I promise to explain to you, Nasara. Thank you very much. Yeah, I did not forget, but we got this call here. Anyway. The Quran says that the Hawariyin of the Messiah, they said to the Messiah, "Nahnu Ansarullah, amanna billah." This is Nasara, Ansar, which means we are the helpers of Allah. And here, this is another disaster in the Quran. Then when Isa came to know of their disbelief, he said, "Who will be my helpers in Allah's cause?" Helper. This is Nasara. And now, anyone notice the stupidity? Additional that we are not Nasara. Forget about we are not Nasara now. Who here noticed the stupidity in this story? In the word Nasara specifically. Let us see which one of us is a very smart thinker. Anyone knows? There is something very bad here. Very stupid. Get Muhammad busted. I'm going to log off Skype because she will not call for sure. And I don't want to talk more. Anyone notice the problem? There is something very bad. Okay, hold on. The Muslim today, they call us Nasara, correct? They call us Nasara, right? Okay. Do you know what the Muslims are calling us? The helpers of Allah. I mean, how stupid are you to say we are going to go to hell and our name yet is the helpers of Allah? You see here, we are the helpers of Allah. This is the Nasara, yeah? They are translating the word Nasara. We are the helpers of Allah. So the donkey who says, and his name is Muhammad, that the Christians are Nasara, but yet they will go to hell. How are you calling the Ansar, the helpers of Allah, they will go to hell? Because you cannot be the helper of Allah, and yet you will go to hell. That is the most stupid statement ever. This is a statement, even a certified donkey would not say it. It's like I saying to you, you are the helper of the firefighter, but you will go to hell. And how we get the honor to be the helpers of Allah? We are not Muslims, we are the helper of Allah. We are higher. You know what I'm saying? We are not the same as the Muslims. We are higher. We are the helpers of Allah. Allah need our help. Allah do not need the help of anyone except the Nasara, the Christians, supposedly. How stupid this statement is. But what do you say when a donkey, he talk? He don't talk, he do poo-poo. It's like saying that to Sam Shamoun, the guy with the hair. But he don't have a hair. How you call him Nasara? Are they still Nasara? Yes, they are Nasara. Huh? But that means their name is the helper of Allah. Yeah, this is his own. This is our interpretation, my friend. Nasara. Yeah, I know what Rashid is saying to you. But according to Islam, I'm talking here according to Islam, not according to us. Our explanation is different from the Muslim explanation. But the Muslim explanation is this. And the word Nasara is not about Nasara, no. The word Nasara, the Nazareth, is a word in Aramaic, or in Hebrew, sorry, which means the poor. The poor. Who called them the poor? The Christian, they reject those people. They are a Christian cult, like Jehovah's Witnesses. So they call them the poor because they have a poor understanding of the Bible. Muhammad the fool, he do not know what the word mean. Nasara. The same as the word in the Quran when he says that Azar is the father of Abraham. How Azar became the father of Abraham? Because Muhammad the fool, he do not know Aramaic. He think that the word Azar, which means a foolish, is the name of the father of Abraham. But Abraham was saying to his father, Azar, which means foolish. Do you want to worship? This is foolish. It's foolish to worship idols. This is what he's saying. Muhammad was copying the book of Waraq ibn Nawfal, who he is saying there that Abraham, he said to his father, Azar. Muhammad the fool, he thought this is the name of the father. Yeah, the Nazarenes in the Bible is different from the Nasara, the Nazara, the Nazarite, which word means poor. This is a different word. That word is about people who follow the Messiah from the city of the Nasira. Anyway, did we have a good time together? Was it good? I'm not going to keep you here for long. I mean, you guys in the Philippines, in India, in Indonesia, you must be working now, you know, at work. So I hope we have a good time together and we learn something good. And I'm very happy that this lady, she called me. I really respect that she's trying her best to defend Islam and she is brave. Not like the potato who have a big beard, but they don't dare to call me. They are intimidated. And she was a great help, actually, to make a lot of Muslims leave Islam. I don't know how many people will watch this video and they will see how Muslims, they defend something they cannot defend. And that makes their defense funny. Desperately. And the more they defend, the more they dig in the sand to expose Muhammad. I will try to be here again tomorrow, God is willing. It's time to go. I want to say thank you guys for your help and support. Don't forget to download the videos. As you know, we don't keep them. And if you don't like our video, give it dislike. Don't forget. If you like it, give it like. If you like to subscribe, subscribe. But I will give you better advice. Don't subscribe. Because if you subscribe and you unsubscribe, Allah will give you a reward, double reward. So if you are a Muslim, I advise you to subscribe immediately. And then unsubscribe right after. This is the logic of Islam. Very silly, stupid cult. So thank you very much for being here. May the Lord bless you all. And every day we prove that the truth, nobody can hide it. Nobody. No matter how much they make videos to deceive us about science and the Quran, all this garbage. It's very easy to get it busted. But be aware that there's many children, they can be falling into the trap they come with. Media is very powerful. And those who never heard us, they are exposed. Because they didn't know. They didn't speak Arabic. They have no idea what Islam is about. And usually, when somebody is religious with a beard, we think that he's a decent person telling us the truth. They do not know that this is an evil cult, and they are willing to lie as much as they can because it's lawful to lie. That's why Islam is very dangerous, because people assume that when they speak to a believer, he's speaking to a person who is against lying. Even they will show you the Prophet says don't lie, but they will not tell you that the Prophet says lie in three cases. One of them to your wife and your family, which is disgusting. The other one to your friends, supposed to fix a problem. And the third one in the case of war. But they will not tell you that Islam is in war with everybody. Anyone reject Islam, Allah in war with him. So if you are a Hindu, Allah in war with you. If you are a Buddha, Allah in war. If you are an atheist, Christian, doesn't matter. Allah in war with anyone. Muhammad, he said, I've been ordered to fight and kill all mankind. For sure, except the Muslims. Until they say there's no God but Allah and there's no prophet but Mumu. And then if they do so, they have to slaughter as we slaughter, eat as we eat, and pray as we pray, and pay the zakat, and then and only then I will not shed their blood unless by the law of Allah. Even then, nothing will protect their property and their money and their blood unless they convert to Islam. That is Islam. It's a gang, it's Hitler, it's fascism. Actually, let me show you this before we go. Just to give you an idea, final idea. Because still, some people, they are naive and they will not accept that Islam is fascist. Read carefully with me and tell me, what do you think? Is that fascism or this is something else? Do you have a name for, do you have different name for this fascism teaching? You are the best of the people ever raised for the benefit of mankind. When you see this benefit of mankind, Muslims are the best for the benefit. Look at the benefit. You see the word benefit? You say, wow, that's good. I mean, obviously, they don't mean a harm. It says benefit. But look what the benefit of mankind is. Chapter 3, verse 110. The best of all mankind are those who bring them, who? Mankind, with the chain around their necks till they embrace Islam. And is that a hadith which is accepted? Yes, this is Sahih al-Bukhari. Is it authentic? Absolutely. This is Hitler. Hitler making a speech saying, you are the best of mankind, go bring everybody with a chain around their neck. This is the truth. Without makeup, there's many Muslims, many people, they get upset from me. They say, you are very harsh, you are very tough. My friend, our topic is disgusting. We're fighting the god of terrorism. And you people thinking about the mentality of giving me a hug. I'm not here to give hugs. Some Christians, they have mentality of giving hugs. They think they can bring people to Christ by giving them hugs. You have first to cleanse their brain from all the garbage. Leave the hugs for later. People need the truth, not your hugs. If the whole problem in the world can be solved by hugs, that's it. Everything is good to go. Let us start hugging. So wake up. The best way to do it as we do it. After you clean their brain from the stupidity and hatred and terrorism and the war mentality, and this, if you notice, she was talking to me, yes, if it's in war, I was asking her, is it okay for you to force somebody as a Christian to walk in the sewage? She said, well, it's in the war, yes. Do you see how the Islam teaching you to be fascist? This is a girl saying it's okay for her to force a Christian to walk in the sewage if it's a wartime. Even if he's just walking in the street. Islam is a supremacist cult. White supremacist cult. Think that because they are Muslims, they have the right to put a chain around your neck, force you to walk in the sewage, force you to live like a dog. You are not even equal to a human being. It's a white Arab supremacist garbage cult. And the second you believe in it, you are part of this mafia. Please download the video, share it with your friends, and until we see you soon again, Christ is Lord, Islam is false, and we'll see you soon again. Take care, bye-bye.